everyone. My name is Siyamthanda Ndlela. I'm from Indlezana Yezwa organization, an NPO which works on GBV, supporting survivors and victims of gender-based violence and making sure that they get justice. We also do victim empowerment in partnership with other NPOs. I have been asked to talk about myself and a bit of my feminism work. I joined the activism space at a very young age, and I started becoming more active when I joined the hashtag The Total Shutdown in 2018, where I was part of the leadership in the Eastern Cape, and more specifically in Mthatha. We all made the total shutdown a success, and it was the beginning of the journey to a woman getting justice in South Africa, women's rights being noticed and being acknowledged everywhere, people knowing that women also have rights. So far with the project that I am doing with the Foundation of Human Rights, we are doing a Masibambisane project, which its aim is to create or make gender-based violence free zones. Our project site is Tsolo in the Eastern Cape at New Homes location. We chose this area because we had an incident where a young lady was raped by 11 men, which showed us that there is a problem in that area and we need to work on it, because it is not normal for 11 men to rape one person coming in different groups at the same night. This project of Masibambisane has been helpful to a lot of people, because we have a multi-stakeholder forum, we have the youth within us in Tsolo, so it's helping, and we have street committees who also help the police to patrol the area, making sure that it's a safe place, safe for women, safe for children, in terms of their patrolling and the unity that they've built within the community. They even managed to track down some stolen goods, which they gave to the police. They would assist police in arresting suspects for certain cases, suspects who would be within their communities. There are a lot of successful stories that has happened within the street committees of Masibambisane. They are just making sure that everything is well within their area. The challenges at local and national in making SA free from GBV, there are a lot. There are people who still don't take gender-based violence cases serious. There are departments who still don't play their roles when it comes to fighting gender-based violence. And we still feel that they still need to get trained. We still have police who re-victimize victims. We still have social workers who don't give victims or survivors the necessary attention they need when they go to their offices. Because when you go to a social worker's office being a victim of rape, you have hope that when you get out of there, uzophuma ufumene some sort of counseling or trauma debriefing session, you know, but you're gonna get someone to speak with regarding your problem and get some comfort, but you wouldn't find that in some places. So there's still a long journey that we have to go, but we still need to train these people on GPVF. I think I have said so much, but we still need to work on GBV in terms of making all those GBVF free zones a success. And we must make sure that in South Africa, each and every area is made a GBVF free zone. Thank you.